Boeing facing a new setback to its space ambitions. NASA announcing over the weekend that it will not use Boeing's faulty Starliner craft to send home astronauts stuck at the International Space Station. The agency deciding it's safer to use Elon Musk's SpaceX. Boeing's down by almost 1%. Guy Johnson joins us for more out of London. Guy, how much of a setback is this? How embarrassing is this for Boeing?
It's hugely embarrassing. Of course, it's hugely embarrassing. They sent two astronauts up. They were meant to be up there for a week. They've been up there a couple of months, and now they're going to be up there until the beginning of next year. You've got to reconfigure a whole load of capsules, both on the SpaceX side and also on the Boeing side. They're going to bring the capsule that went up back uncrewed because they can't run the risk of bringing the two astronauts back in it. It's got thruster issues, and they're concerned about what the re-entry would ultimately look like. This is a program, John, that is already billions over a budget, and it's behind schedule. It's been like this for quite some time. Boeing is saying that it is committed to the program, but remember, you've got a new CEO coming in. He's got a blank piece of paper, and he's looking at everything right now. So, yeah, it's hugely embarrassing. It's also potentially financially very consequential. There is a lot already invested in this program. What happens to it next will matter to Boeing shareholders.
You alluded to it, Guy. Build on that just a little bit. How blank is that piece of paper? Does he really have, does the incoming CEO really have the option of stepping away from that business?
I think everything is on the table. Look, you have to figure out how you're going to right the ship. Let's say it is still a priority. Kind of how high is it in terms of the list of things that need to get done? How big a priority is it? Does he need to make sure that the civil side of the business is fixed first? Can he do it all? Is there enough bandwidth to actually solve all the problems simultaneously? There are lots of things going on at Boeing at the moment. The civil business definitely needs to be put back on an even keel. The MAX program, what happens with the MAX replacement is the next big challenge there. What is happening with the 87? What's happening with the 777X? There are lots and lots of challenges that need to be resolved for this company. You come back to the space program, yeah, sure, it's going to be an issue and it's going to be something that this company has to resolve. But when does that ultimately happen? And do you have the luxury of time when SpaceX is doing what it's doing right now? Remember that it's got another launch going up. It's about to have another launch going up. It's going to be sending astronauts up. They're going to spend time in one of the highest orbits that we've ever seen. It is making progress. The problem here is you've got a competitor that is doing it better and faster. Do you stick with the program and continue to make losses? It's a really big challenge. Boeing has limited resources. It's got to figure out where it wants to spend them.
I would turn it on its head, Guy. Why should they continue with a program that has left them with losses where they're falling behind?
Because of so much that has been invested already, Lisa, and because this is going to be an area of growth going forward. Can Boeing afford not to be in space? I think is a key question that this company needs to answer. And I think that is going to be the challenge. It's really difficult to answer it at the moment. At some point, this business is going to be profitable. How much you need to put into it, how many resources, human resources, financial resources need to go into it to get to that point remains a really difficult question. This is unbelievably complex stuff that you're dealing with here. We all know that. And as a result of which, it's just a resource issue. But can you afford not to be in this? Ultimately, if further down the road, this turns out to be a hugely profitable part of your business. It's a really difficult question. And there's so many unknowns here. Kelly Orbach's got some really difficult challenges and questions that he's got to answer. We don't know yet. At the moment, he says he's committed. But this company is falling behind SpaceX in a very big way at the moment.